Yes, I know I'm skipping some episode because I want to talk about this one Total Dramarama episode in particular that's receiving the most attention. Whenever I watch a full episode of Total Dramarama Season 2, one of my biggest complaints is that there's barely anything new that we've seen in Season 2. Everything just felt the same as Season 1. What I mean is that we've been through the same adventure that we've done before in the previous Total Dramarama Season 1 episodes. From the liar reveals to the misunderstandings to encounter something out of the ordinary that can be considered stupid or inconsistent or trying to get out of trouble. Don't believe me? There is actually an episode where the Total Drama Kids had to deliver something sweet before Chef finds out, which in this case is chocolate buns. And we already did that in a Season 1 episode of Total Dramarama, and that's Duck Duck Juice. The only difference is, it's chocolate. In addition, there was actually an episode where Izzy plays supervillain again. Doesn't that sound familiar? Maybe in a future Total Drama vlog, I might talk about those episodes again, but for now, let's talk about the one episode in question, Dissing Cousins. What makes this episode stand out is that we finally had some additional characters from the original Total Drama series. Not a cameo like MacArthur or sometimes Josh and Don. Not a pointless background character like with Jeff, Katie, DJ, and the rest. We actually have two additional characters that are considered the main characters of this episode, and they are Max and Ella. Before we talk about the episode, I might want to give a little recap on what do I think about these two characters. I actually like Ella. I thought she was a likable character. She had a beautiful singing voice, and she was actually useful in multiple challenges, especially with her taming of the animals. Max, however, I don't like him at all. I actually find him pretty annoying. Him alongside Leonard are pretty much the most annoying characters in Total Drama Pocketeel Island. He never did anything for me because he's obviously one joke. He thinks he's evil, but he has a soft side. Even during his time in Season 5, Part 2, or Season 6, or whatever, he never did anything useful. Whenever he let someone else, like Scarlet, do all of his evil duties, he pretty much proved himself like he did the whole thing by himself. The only time that I consider him as a three-dimensional character is with the episode Three Zones and a Baby, where he has a soft side with Baby because we find out in an audition that he did some babysitting jobs. And that's about it. Now, for their role in the episode Dissing Cousins, it takes place on International Cousins Day, and Max and Ella are happy to be cousins of Owen and Gwen because fanfiction.net is taking over writing again. Okay, I'll let this slide for now because I don't consider this entire series canon. Gwen at first was actually happy that Ella was coming because she might release her inner rampage, but when she appeared at the daycare, she seems pretty sweet, much to Gwen's disappointment, and now she's on a goal to make Ella snap. Owen was most concerned in Max's arrival because of his evil behavior, and Max is hosting a Minions competition. The rest of the characters but Owen play along because they actually believe that he's not evil, so Owen volunteer himself to be in this Minions competition to save everyone. And yeah, I don't blame the characters outside of Owen. Can you actually believe that Max is actually the most evil character of the show? Yeah, but then suddenly, when they host the Minions competition, they are actually deadly. The sandbox has been turned to a quicksand, Max has a deadly snake, he released some wild squirrels, and he somehow brought a shredder to the playground at the end of the slide. And he even has toxic waste. Whoa! What is up with this competition? Are you sure this really is Max and not the villain from Austin Powers as the little kid? But the craziest thing about this episode in particular, I actually like Max in this episode than I did in the actual Pocketeel season. What do we know about Max in Pocketeel Island? He wants to be evil, but he has a soft side. Even at the beginning of the season, the other contestants knew he wouldn't be a deadly threat to them. In fact, some characters might consider him annoying like Scarlet or a laughing joke like Sugar. In fact, when I saw Pocketeel Island for the first time, I figured Max should have been eliminated before Ella. He just got ridiculously lucky because of Chris's dumb punishment for Ella. In the Total Dramarama episode, he is both a softie and a serial killer, and that's probably what was missing for Max the entire time on Season 5, Part 2. If Max had both of those personalities in Pocket Tail Island, he could have been a likable character and a legitimate threat to everyone's game. And when it comes to Ella's role in this one, they almost got her right. From the looks of it, she still sounds the same. She still has the beautiful voice, the iconic pink suit, but then they add this additional feature that is so not right. Apparently in the past she was originally a green hideous monster, but after she got some etiquette lessons, she's now sweet and innocent. But Gwen is on a goal to make her snap so she can turn into a monster again. Why? We don't need something this out of the ordinary. We didn't have to put that in. Ella is always happy most of the time, but even when she does get mad, she doesn't do anything like this. If you want to enforce the idea that she secretly has an anger issue, that's a good idea. But if you want to do it, just make her act like a wild animal. Don't make her be one. When it comes to their interactions with the Total Drama characters, they're actually pretty good, including their cousins. But I have to admit, when Ella and Max start interacting with each other when Ella participated in the Minions competition, I got a few laughs when Ella outperforms Max's competitions. And to be fair, the ending is a little bit sweet. I mean, the climax is stupid. I mean, incredibly stupid because of the you-know-what. But it was actually really nice that both Owen and Max and even Gwen and Ella reached a compromise. So yeah, I guess you might well consider it as one of the good Total Dramarama episodes of Season 2. But it's a little debatable if you really want to see it. Some Ella fans might not like this because of what they did to her, especially with that additional feature. But I can see some huge Max fans have a blast with this episode if they really want to see more adventures with him. In conclusion, it was some episode, but the biggest question is, will they bring back Ella and Max back for future episodes, or better yet, bring in more additional characters? This is another wait and see.